Hi guys, Robert here from teamisle.com and I welcome you to our channel. Today I'm gonna show you how to create graphs like this one using Charts Visualizer plugin for WordPress and how to integrate them into your site content. After you install and activate the plugin, head to Media Visualizer Library. Here are 9 types of graphs and charts you can build, plus 3 more available in the premium version of the plugin: pie, line, area, geo, bar, column, gauge, scatter, candlestick, then table, timeline, and combo for premium users. Click on Add New above, then choose your preferred chart type. On the next screen, then click Next. For this tutorial, I will choose the scatter chart. Here is the preview, along with all necessary settings, in the right sidebar. You can choose to import data from a file, URL, or from other charts as well. If you are unsure about how to format your data, then please take a look at this sample. You can edit this file with your own data and insert more info as well. Re-upload the file here, then click to import data. You can see the changes instantly in the preview. Next, access the advanced settings to set a title for your chart. Choose font family and size. Set legend position and alignment along with the font color, then choose some tooltip settings. The horizontal axis settings consist of 6 options you can set as you wish. The axis title is what you see in the footer of your chart. Change the text position and you can see the numbers on the left side of your chart moving when you toggle through options. Set direction, in which the values along the horizontal axis grow, using these options from the drop-down list. Then set baseline color and axis text color for the best visual experience. The final step here is where you can enter custom format pattern to apply to horizontal axis labels using the information below. Next is to set the grid lines count and choose a color for them. You can set some minor grid lines as well to make the chart more accurate. And for the final horizontal axis settings, you can choose the maximum value and the minimum value for the viewing window. Use the same instruction created for horizontal axis settings to set vertical axis as well, then move to line settings. Set the line width and point size here, then choose a curve type from the drop-down below. The selection mode will determine how many data points a user can select in chart, and aggregation target will determine how multiple data selections are rolled up into tooltips. To make it work, you need to set multiple selection mode and tooltip trigger to display it when a user selects an element. The point opacity is something you can set from 0.0 as fully transparent to 1.0 as completely opaque here. Click on Save Chart and then you will be able to set visibility, line width, point size, number format, curve type and color as well for all series including your custom one. The last advanced settings for a chart are layout and chart area. In the layout section, you can configure the total size of the chart. 2 formats are supported: a number or a number followed by percent. A simple number is a value in pixels. A number followed by percent is a percentage. Continue configuring the background color for the main area of the chart, then the chart border width and color. Planning to display it with transparent background? Tick this. For the chart area, you can configure the placement and size where the chart itself is drawn, excluding axis and legends. 2 formats are supported here as well. Now that we are finished all the settings for this chart, let's integrate it into a page. Click Save Chart, then copy the shortcode generated in the bottom left corner for that particular chart. Create a new page named Report, for example, and paste the shortcode in the text editor. Let's see it in action now. It works perfectly and has good integration with the page layout, whether it's displayed in full width or on a default page with sidebar. To edit a chart, head back to Media, Visualizer Library, then click on the Edit icon below the one you wish to edit information for. Notice that you can add more useful graphics to your actual chart by choosing the line or area type, for example, then click Next and edit settings as needed. You can use the instructions in this video to create any of the charts available with this plugin. And if you need me to create a tutorial for one of them, let me know in the comments below this video. Thanks for watching. Click the parrot on the screen right now to subscribe, then click the bell and check send all notifications for this channel. This way, you'll be notified every time we upload our latest tutorials about WordPress. Share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question in comments below.